Okay, we are very excited again. We have been digging maybe for half an hour, and I actually asked Mike to come and dig over here. And I think he's very happy that he did.
I am.
We are back again with Iron Mike metal detecting. Today it's me and him. He also brought his son. Last time when we were here, we had a lot of fun. Yeah, it's probably gonna be another one of those days. A lot of digging. My knees will probably hurt at the end of the day. There's just stuff everywhere here. So yeah, wish us luck. Me and Mike are just wandering around and we just found this very neat foxhole. You can clearly see the entry right there. And this will be the place where the soldiers would lay down and aim their rifles that way somewhere probably. And there's yet another one, a very classic shape. I can see the entry of the foxhole somewhere over here. And then there's two edges that are sticking out a bit. For size comparison, this one is massive. There would have been multiple guys in here, definitely. That's history right there. We're back at it. Mike started in a dump pit right over there. And I started in a dump pit over here. And yeah, I decided to continue my work in this pit. And I just excavated a little bit of the edge of this dugout here, this dump pit. And another one of those name tags came up. This just fell out of the side. I thought that I should get my camera to show to you. So here it is. And yeah, I found this in a previous video. And I think it's a name tag from a storage locker or maybe a soldier's chest, basically a chest to keep some stuff in. And they would label it, they would give it a name label. And I think this one says Westenberg. Yeah, so that's a very personal item. That's very cool. And I'm gonna be very careful with this because I think it's ink, actually, the letters, so I don't want to rub it too much or something. But yeah, that's definitely a cool one. Personal name tag from a soldier. Okay, we are very excited again. We have been digging maybe for half an hour, 45 minutes, not too much stuff. I was digging over in this edge over here, and I actually asked Mike to come and dig over here. And I think he's very happy that he did.
I am.
Because, yeah, you can see that small plane right there. He just found it in this edge. And it's again a Winterhilfswerke badge. And we found one in one of my previous videos. And yeah, this is another one. There were really, really a lot of these Winterhilfswerke badges.
Let me just turn it around for you.
Yeah, and this is one of them.
This is the upside, of course.
Yeah. Guys, we found a sponsor for this video. Lately, I've been playing this game War Thunder a lot. It's a military vehicle combat online game, which is free to play on PC, PS4 and Xbox One. It's also cross-platform between PC and consoles. No purchase necessary, simply download and play. Make your pick from an incredible arsenal of more than 1500 historically accurate playable tanks, aircrafts, helicopters and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. I am sure that you guys will appreciate the World War II battlefields that are available. Want to step in an airplane and take part in the Battle of Britain? Or do you prefer to be a tank commander in the Battle for Stalingrad? Take your shot at it. It's free on PC, PS4 and Xbox One. Register now using the link in the video description and you'll get a bonus of a premium tank, aircraft or ship and a 3-day account upgrade. Quite some detail on it. This typical German, these crosses there. Yeah, the collection is growing of these Winterhilfswerke badges, I guess. So yeah, the idea was it was like a charity and people could buy these tokens and get some funding for the people who needed warm clothing and that sort of stuff in cold periods of time. At least that's what I read online. So.
That's right, and the motto was no one shall freeze or starve. And actually the Hitlerjugend, they went door to door to sell these.
Wow. Yeah. This is all pay dirt right here. There's fines here everywhere. The ground is very consolidated. And there's metal and porcelain everywhere. So I don't want to dig this out too fast. I don't want to miss anything. More than I already probably do, but I will never know it. And that's probably for the better. There's just objects here everywhere. Glass, porcelain, metal. And I'm also finding many of these small perfume bottles. And this one actually has some writing. I think it's German writing. I'm not sure, but yeah, these are quite cool. Quite a common find here. Finally, the first piece of porcelain with a nice recognizable stamp on it. It says Weiden 1935. So this was probably a cup, but yeah, not that much left. Right next to this piece of porcelain, it's a complete German eagle with the swastika. And yeah, usually we find them broken up. There is even more. We just dug up these two pieces of porcelain and this very nice German belt hook just came out. I think almost all soldiers would wear these, keep their belt in place. And they're very recognizable with these two squares and a J-shaped hook. Cool find again. Still working in the same area. More and more finds keep coming up. And I just excavated this chain. And I think it's a chain for a pocket watch. Could be wrong, but nice one. Nice little chain. Let's see if we can find the pocket watch. As you probably know by now, we find many broken porcelain pieces over here. Like this one. Broken cup with the part of the German eagle on it. And I thought it would be funny to show you this piece here. There will probably be a German eagle on this. Yes, I think it's complete. Okay, let's see. Yes, there is actually a German eagle on it. German Wehrmacht porcelain cup. Check this out, guys. Major size comp. I guess this soldier had some serious hair going on. Not too far away from where Mike just found that airplane, the WHW badge. So, next little find that I want to show you is this pocket knife. So there's so many different pieces of relics here all together. It's really amazing. Well, this is quite an interesting find, something that I've never found before and something that I never will find with a metal detector. It's a piece of, photo paper, I guess you would call it. And since this has been in the ground for so many years, we're definitely never gonna find out what was once on these photos, but I guess it would have been a remarkable image of that time frame. Still a very cool find. Just another nice small little find. This is a piece of plastic which would go behind the German gas mask eyes to stop condensation. And there's some writing on it. It says Innenseite 1940. Yeah, the Germans were well known for marking almost everything. Wow, I really can't believe this. We just had a really funny moment. I'm here with Mike and his son. And his son just came walking by and asked us what this was. And you're looking here at the trash pile where me and Mike decided to dig further. But this was already on the surface. So we must have missed it. Yeah, Mike's son has done a good job by pointing us out that this was still here. Because this is an officer's cap emblem. It's the oak leaves basically. And there will be like a silver circle with a red dot in the middle. They would wear this on the front of the cap. So that's actually a really, really nice find. Probably the best find so far here. So yeah, I probably dug this up, but I must have missed it. So very nice find. Officer's cap emblem. This cap emblem originally consisted of a wreath and cockade. The red is the oak leaves part, and the cockade is the silverish circle with a red dot in the middle. It was worn by German officers and enlisted men. It would have been placed on the peaked visor cap, which is called Schirmmütze in German. We only found the red. The cockade is missing in the emblem that we found. Me and Mike are still working on this dump pit, and I thought that this would be a funny find to show you. Found this before on the Eastern Front. Yeah, it has this very specific shape with a V in it like this, and there's a pin on it. I believe that this is a Wehrmacht cavalry tag, or it would be placed on horse-drawn vehicles. So yeah, Wehrmacht find, the vehicle tag basically. Don't find these too often. I don't know how many pieces we found already with the German eagle on it, but here's yet another piece. So much history here. We just dug up some small bottles. More and more, they keep coming. And we might have something interesting again. You can see something shiny right here. I think it's a stripe from a uniform. Maybe a piece that was attached on the shoulder boards, something to indicate the rank of a soldier. I'm quite sure, I mean, there's so much detail on it, so much shine. So this might be something really cool. I wanted to show you an overview of the finds that I personally found today. Well, the things that I'm taking home at least. You'll probably recognize some relics from last time. We found some similar things. We found quite a lot of comms in different colors. A very nice nameplate, Westenberg. These tunic belt buckles, found two of them. Then there's some coins, some porcelain, some German eagles, some German gas mask eyes. They're all stamped, they all have a nice date on them. But the officer's cap emblem was definitely the most spectacular find of the day. And of course, Mike also found some really cool stuff today. Similar finds like mine, but Mike also found Winterhilfswerke German airplane, which is very cool. Don't forget to check out War Thunder, guys. Play for free on PC, PS4 and Xbox One. You can register via the link in the video description so you can enjoy a bonus of a premium tank, aircraft or ship and a 3-day account upgrade. Our bags are packed, our knees hurt as promised. Yeah, we really found some interesting pieces of history today. I hope you enjoyed the video, maybe you even learned something today. Don't forget to check out our Patreon if you want to look behind the scenes. A big thank you to all of my patrons. Your names will appear on the screen right now. Really appreciate your support. Also, don't forget to check out Iron Mike Metal Detecting. He has an amazing YouTube channel. See you guys next video. Cheers.